Hello and welcome to another TA Tech Tip. In this tech tip, we'll show you how to set up a temperature ramp on the DMA 850.
The sample in this tech tip is a polycarbonate sample run on a single cantilever clamp and clamped with 8 to 10 inch pounds of torque.
To begin an experiment, click Experiments under the File Manager. For a simple experiment, select Express Mode. First, set up the name and file path and any other details. Next, select Clamp and input the relevant measurements. These will be used to calculate the strain and stress values when setting up the experiment. The final section is the experimental parameters. Select Oscillation, Temperature Ramp. The following is a typical starting point for reasonable parameters. Your experiment may require customization depending on the sample, clamp, and temperature ranges. Under Test Settings, you can select the following options. We will use the default deformation mode, Amplitude. Direct strain allows the instrument to control the strain continuously. We will keep the default data sampling mode of 3 seconds per point. We will use the standard data acquisition. Save waveform allows for a graphical force displacement waveform to be saved for each point and viewed later. Under auto range mode, we will use a minimum force of 0.001 newtons and a maximum displacement of 1 millimeter. Next, we will set our test parameters for the temperature ramp. The first parameter to consider is the amplitude. Typically, 20 microns is a good starting point for most clamps and most samples. The frequency will be set at 1 Hz and is appropriate for most applications of this test. For the temperature, we set a start and end temperature. We can also set use current temperature to set the start temperature as the current temperature of the instrument. The ramp rate should be selected such that it does not change the result of the experiment. Typically, it is chosen to be between 1 and 5 degrees C per minute. This allows the sample to remain in thermal equilibrium with the current temperature during the temperature ramp test. We can also set a soak time for the start temperature. If we are not starting at ambient, we should add an approximate 5-minute soak time. At the end temperature, we can set a final soak time to make sure that the instrument reaches the final temperature and this sample is stable. The high temperature should not be set such that the sample melts or degrades in the furnace. The post-test conditions allow the user to set the clamp mode after the test to be float, unlock, or lock position. The temperature control can be set to maintain the final temperature, disable the temperature control, or set final temperature to go to the temperature in the field below at the end of the test. For some clamps, there are initial or preload force and force track options. These options are necessary to obtain correct results with certain clamp types. When one of these clamps is selected as the active geometry, these options will appear here. The cantilever and shear sandwich clamps do not require a preload force and force track. The tension, compression, and three-point bend clamps do. Typical preload forces are in the range of 0.01 to 2 newtons, depending on the stiffness of the sample and clamp type. A force track of 125% is typical for most samples. Users should choose a force just small enough to keep the sample taut or in contact with the movable clamp, yet not so large that the sample begins to deform or creep due to it. The tension clamp will also have an additional option to measure the length after the initial temperature equilibration in the test settings. This option is called Measure Again After Method Equilibration. In this tech tip, we showed you how to set up a temperature ramp on the DMA 850. Stay tuned for more helpful tips from TA Instruments, and thank you for your interest.